Hi. Let's continue our study of equations. We are going to use the following useful device, which is order reduction. So what I am talking about? Consider the equation y double prime plus p of x y prime plus q of x y equals zero. So this is a homogeneous equation, but this time it has variable coefficients. P and q are some continuous functions. And suppose we know its solution y1 of x. No, sometimes it is obvious. We look at the equation and see immediately that this function is solution. But the second solution can be a problem. So we are going to find another solution y of x. I write y of x because I am talking about arbitrary solution. We know that there exists two linearly independent solutions of homogeneous equation, and any solution is a linear combination of these solutions. But the choice of these two basic solutions is more or less arbitrary. So if you find some solution y of x which is linearly independent of y1, it can be taken as the second solution, y2. Then any other solution will be combination of y1 and y2. So now I would say that if you know one solution of this equation, how can it help to solve any other solution? To this end, we make the following trick. Let us look for solution y of x in the form y of x equals, say, u of x times y1 of x. It cannot help much. It appears it cannot help much because any function, whatever, can be written in this form if y1 of x is not zero, of course. So if this solution y1 is not zero everywhere, then we are looking for solution in this form everywhere. If it is zero somewhere at some points, then we are working beyond these points. These points are in some sense singular. So yx is has this form. So let us substitute y equals u y1. No, x is assumed here into the equation. To do it, we have to find first derivatives, first and second derivatives. So, y equals u times y1. Y prime, no, it is a product, so I differentiate it as a product. U prime y1 plus u y1 prime. Y double prime equals u double prime y1 plus u prime y1 prime plus u prime y1 prime plus u y1 double prime. No, it is simply equals u double prime y1 plus 2 u prime y1 prime plus u1 y1 double prime. So we have these derivatives. Now let us substitute this into the equation. I will need possibly some space. Y double prime plus PXY plus QXY, let me write here, Y double prime plus p y prime plus q y equals the following. U double prime y1 plus 2 u prime y1 prime plus y1 double prime plus p y prime is here u prime y1 plus u y1 prime plus q u y1. Now here we can kill some terms, because if you take u times y1 prime double prime plus p u y1 prime plus q u y1, u y1 double prime plus p y1 prime plus q y1, and this is zero because y1 is solution of homogeneous equation of this equation. So what remains plus u double prime y1 plus u prime here and here, u prime times 2 y1 prime plus p y1 p y1. So this is zero. Equals zero, so equals u double prime y1 plus u prime times 2 y1 prime plus PY1. And this should be zero, because I substituted our combination U times Y1, and I look for solution of this equation. So this should be zero. Now you see here you have second derivative of U and first derivative, and U does not appear itself. So let us introduce the function V of X equals U prime of X. So V prime of X equals U double prime of X. And so our equation is V prime Y1 plus V times 2 Y1 prime plus P Y1 equals 0. Now let's observe that you know Y1, you know Y1 prime, and you know P. So this is a known function. Yes, no, to be consistent, more consistent with our previous theory, let us divide it by Y1. We assume that Y1 is not zero in the domain, in the interval where we are solving. So let us divide it by Y1. And we have the following, V prime plus 2 Y1 prime divided by 1 plus P, I divided by times V equals 0. No, it is the simplest canonical linear first order equation. And we immediately find that V equals e to the power integral C. E to the power integral, in here is 2 Y1 prime divided by Y1 plus P dx. This is V. Now V is derivative of U. So U of X equal integral C E integral 2 Y1 prime divided by Y1 plus P dx plus C1. Yes? And at last we have Y equals this function, let me denote this, equals, say, u0 of x plus c1. u0 is what is written here. So u is this, and y of x equals u0 of x Y1 of X plus C1 times Y1 of X. Yes? That's it. We found a function. So U0 of X is some function which is not constant because it is integral of some function which is positive. If C is positive and this exponent, so it is positive. Yeah. So at least it is a growing function. So this means that u0, this integral, is not a constant. It is growing function. No, depending on C, it may be growing and may be decreasing. Let me write it. C u0 plus c1. This means that we found two linearly independent functions. This is one function, y1, and this the function y2 equals c y2 of x plus c1 y1 of x. No, instead of c, we can write it c2 for symmetry. And now this is the general derivation, but God forbid if you will try to memorize these formulas and solve if you will have such situation that you have to solve this equation, solve this way using these formulas. Yes, please don't do it. You have only memorized that you are looking for solution, general solution y, in the form y equals some function u times known solution y1, if it is known. Yes, then if you start doing this, these formulas will bring you to the happy end anyway, and you will not be bound by these long formulas which nobody memorizes and nobody uses. It is just for general explanation that it is always possible to find solution. Now I wanted to show you some examples how we can use it, and you will see that it is easy and even fun. Okay, so consider examples. Examples. The first example is you can see it more or less repeats what you had before. Y double prime minus 2 y prime plus y equal 0. Now we can see immediately that y1 of x equals e to the power x. And if you substitute here, you see that this is solution. It is e power x minus 2 e power x plus e power x, it's 0. So the question, how to find the second solution? Please, if you solve the characteristic equation, you see that here we have the double root, so you can have it from the general theory that the second solution is x times e to the power x. Yes, but now I wanted to get it without that theory using this device. So let's write general solution y equals u times y1. y prime equals u prime y1. Let us write from the beginning. U times y1 equals u of x times e to the power x. Y prime equals u prime of x e to the power x plus u x e to the power x. Y double prime x equals u double prime e to the power x plus 2 u prime e to the power x plus u e to the power x equals u double prime plus 2 u prime plus u e to the power x. Let us substitute here. Y double prime minus 2 y prime plus y is the following. Y double prime e to the power x is in all terms, so we write it once, e to the power x, and here we have y double prime u double prime plus 2 u prime plus u minus 2 y prime here minus 2 u prime minus 2 u plus y. Y is u times y1 plus u. Y1 is e to the power x, and here, and it coincides with all its derivative. So what remains? It is e to the power x here, y u double prime, now plus 2 u prime minus 2 u prime. So u prime is none. U minus 2 u plus u. It is also all cancels. So nothing remains but u double prime. It is zero. So u double prime equals zero. U prime equals, let us see, u equals cx plus c1. Yeah? This is u, and y equals uy1 equals cx plus c1 e to the power x equals c1 e to the power x plus cx e to the power x. No, c plays the role of c2. So we see that y2 of x equals x e to the power x. Y1 is e to the power x, and y2 is x e to the power x. Now, this way we restore the result which we had before about solutions of Magini's equation when characteristic equation has double root. Okay, let's consider something a little more advanced. Take another pen. example, x square y double prime plus 3xy prime plus y equals 0. After some looking at this equation, we find one solution. Guess y1 of x equals x to the minus 1 equals 1 over x. No, in fact, y1 prime equals minus 1 over x square. Y1 double prime equals 2 over x cube. Yeah, if you substitute here, it is 2 over x. It is minus 3 over x. And it is 1 over x. So the sum will be 0. So y1 is 1 over x. So I want to find y2. So let me write this equation, multiply by, divide by x square, so that this equation becomes y double prime plus 3 divided by x y prime plus 1 divided by x square y equals 0. It is more convenient. Now you write y equals u of x times y1 of x, which is u of x divided by x. Now let us look for the function u of x. Y prime equals u prime divided by x minus u divided by x square. Y double prime equals u double prime divided by x minus u prime divided by x square. Again, minus u prime from here divided by x square plus two u divided by x cube equals u double prime divided by x minus 2u prime divided by x square plus 2u divided by x cube. Now substitute it into our equation. Y double prime plus 3 over x y prime plus 1 over x square y equals u double prime divided by x minus 2 u prime divided by x square plus 2 u divided by x cube. It is y double prime plus 3 divided by x u prime. 3u prime divided by x square minus 3u divided by x cube, and now plus y divided by x cube plus y y is u divided by x cubed. Now what can you do with this equals u double prime divided by x. Now with u prime minus 2 u prime plus 3 u prime plus plus 2 u divided by x square 2 u prime. Now u divided by x cubed 2 u divided by x cubed minus 3 u divided plus u divided by x cubed. These two terms cancel, 2 minus 3 plus 1. So we have only this, and this should be 0. So we have we can multiply by x u double prime plus 2 divided by x u equals 0, u prime. So u prime equals v, so we have v prime plus 2 divided by x v equals 0. V prime, so dv dx plus 2 divided by x v equal 0. Let us go back. dv over v plus 2 dx over x equals 0. Logarithm modulo v equals minus 2 logarithm modulo x plus c1. V, if you exponentiate, equals minus c, c x minus 2. What is v? V is u prime. U prime is cx minus 2. One moment. Is it correct? Y2 u prime minus 2 u prime plus 3 u prime. Here is just 1. I'm sorry. 1. Yes, I see something wrong. Minus 1. U equals C logarithm X plus C1 modulo X. Oh, at last. Y equals U Y1 y1 was 1 over x equals c logarithm modulo x times 1 over x plus c1 times 1 over x equals c1 times 1 over x plus c2, let me write it c2, plus c2 logarithm modul x divided by x. So you see that here we acquired additional factor logarithm modul x, which is already non-trivial. And at last, let me consider still other example. Okay, so consider one example. One last example. XY double prime minus XY prime plus Y equals 0. Here we can see one obvious solution of this equation, namely y1 of x equals x. If you substitute it here, you see second derivative is 0, first derivative is 1, so it's minus x, this plus x, so they cancel. So following our method, we write arbitrary solution y of x equals x u of x, and look for the function u. So y prime equals x u prime plus u. Y double prime equals x u double prime plus u plus u. One u from here, u prime plus u prime. One u prime from here and other from here equals x u double prime plus 2 u prime. Now let us substitute it here. X y double prime minus x y prime plus y equals x times x u double prime plus 2 u prime minus x u prime x u prime plus u plus x u. equals x square u double prime plus x times 2 u prime 2x u prime minus x square u prime plus x u minus x u. Minus x u plus x u. Now this cancels one is another equals x square u double prime plus 2x minus x square u. And this u prime should be 0. Now let's introduce a new variable v equals u prime. And so we have x square v double prime plus 2x minus x square v equals 0. Now let's divide by x square v prime. We have v prime plus 2 divided by x minus 1 v equals 0. Now this is linear homogeneous first order equation, and we can write v equals c e to the power minus integral 2 divided by x minus 1 dx equals c e to the power minus integral 2 divided by x 2 logarithm x plus x equals c e to the power x divided by x square. So this way we find v. Now v is u prime. So u equals integral v dx equals integral, no, c is here, e x divided by x square dx plus c1. Now what can be said? This integral is not elementary. You cannot find it in the tables. It cannot be expressed in terms of elementary functions. So we have no choice but to leave it. So u equals c integral ex divided by x square dx times x plus c1x. No, this is, let's call it the same, you can call it c2. Yes, so we have the usual expression for general solution of equation, linear combination of two solutions. One solution is x, and other solution is e to the power x. Other solution is defined by this integral which cannot be reduced to something elementary. No, if you cannot solve this integral, you have to leave it in the form of integral. So, you see what can happen. Let us finish this topic, and next time we will continue, and you will see that to solve any non-homogeneous equation, you have to knew a general solution of homogeneous equation and right-hand side, and then everything is reduced to simple integration. No, simple or maybe not very simple. So this is the necessary step, first step to obtain the general solution of homogeneous equation. Therefore, I included this topic. Now let's finish. Have a good time. Bye.